हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू विल डिस्कस अबाउट एन चैप्टर रेशनल नंबर्स। नाउ इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस we have learnt about number line and the representation of types of numbers such as natural numbers, integers and rational numbers and the number line. Now in this chapter we will study rational numbers as a terminating or non-terminating recurring decimals. Okay, now I will briefly explain the previous classes. So we know the natural numbers, whole numbers and integers. Now what is a natural number? We have learnt counting numbers. So counting numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay, so the counting numbers we are called as a natural numbers. And also denoted by the capital English letter. And natural numbers we can be written as n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. We are always represented by three dots only. Suppose the set of even numbers, that is 2, 4, 6 and so on. This is the set of even numbers. We are always represented here. Three dots only. Okay? Right. Now, in natural numbers, which is the least natural number, which is the largest natural number? One is the least natural number and there is no largest natural number. And then next, whole number. What is a whole number? If we include 0 in the collection of all natural numbers to get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. These numbers we call as the whole numbers. So whole numbers are, we are denoted by the symbol W. Whole numbers are, we are can be written as W is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. But now 0 is the least whole number. And there is no largest whole number. Now what is a integer? So whole numbers are including with negative natural numbers. Negative natural numbers are called integers. They are 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. So this is also we can be written as 0 plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 4. So here these are, we are representing on a number line. How to we are representing number line? This is a 0. We draw a line and middle point we put a O. So this O we call as a 0. And right side of the O will divide equal points, equal distance points, and also with in the same way right left side also. right? So this is a 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it is a minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Right now, so here 1, 2, 3, 4 we are called as a increasing numbers and positive numbers. Increasing numbers. So these are we call as a decreasing numbers. Decreasing numbers. Now, so here 1 is a positive. Positive integer. 2 is a positive, 3 is a positive, 4 is a positive, and so on. So here minus 1 is a negative integer. Minus 2 is a negative, minus 3 is a negative, minus 4 is a negative, minus 5 is a negative, and so on. So 0 is a neither positive nor negative. So 0 is neither positive nor negative. And in integers, which is the least positive, which is the least positive integer? So 1 is the least positive integer. Which is the greatest positive integer? There is no greatest positive integer. And which is the greatest negative integer? So minus 1 is the greatest negative integer. And which is the least negative integer? There is no least negative integer. Okay? And now, rational number. So what is a rational number? If n two numbers can be expressed as p by q form, if any two numbers can be expressed as p by q form, where q is not equal to 0 and p comma q are integers, p and q are integers, is called a rational number. If n two numbers can be expressed as p by q form, where q is not equal to 0 and p and q are integers, is called a rational numbers, and denoted by the symbol capital Q. So rational numbers, we are denoted by the symbol capital Q. So rational numbers are also called as quotient numbers. Rational numbers are also called as quotient numbers. For example, 1 by 2, 3 by 4, minus 4 by 5, 2 by 1, minus 4 by 1, etc. That means natural numbers are rational numbers, whole numbers are rational numbers, z is integers are so rational numbers, because so 1 by 1, 2 by 1, 3 by 1, 4 by 1, 5 by 1, 6 by 1, but they are natural numbers, and also they are also rational number. 2 by 1 is a rational, that is in the form of p by q. Now rational numbers we are represented on a number line. How do we are represented on a number line? Now, it is a number line. So here, it is a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. What is a rational number between 0 and 1? That is 0 plus 1 by 2. That is a 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is a rational number in between 0 and 1. What is a rational number in between 1 and 2? That is a 1 plus 2 by 2. 1 plus 2 is a 3. 3 by 2. Okay? Right. Now, what is a rational number between 0 and 1 by 2? So, 0 plus 1 by 2 by 2. That is a 1 by 2 by 2. That is a 1 by 4. And this is a 1 by 4. Now, what is a rational, which rational number in between 0 and 1 by 4? That is a 1 by 8. 1 by 8. And also, which rational number in between 0 and 1 by 8? That is a 1 by 16. And that means, in any how many natural numbers in between 0 and 1. There are many rational numbers are there. Many rational numbers are there. So how many rational numbers in between 0 and 1? Many rational numbers. That is 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16, 1 by 32 and so on. So how many rational numbers between any two numbers? Many rational numbers are infinity. Okay, right. You observe here n in the natural numbers. How many natural numbers in between 2 and 1? There is no natural number. So how many whole numbers in between 2 and 3? In 2 and 3, there is no whole number. It also in integers are, in integers also. So minus 1, 0. In minus 1, 0, which integer is there? There is no integer. But in rational numbers, many rational numbers in between any two rational numbers. Okay, so rational numbers we cannot be written in the form of a set. Rational numbers we cannot be written in the form of a set. Okay, right. Now what is the difference between rational numbers and a fraction? So what is the definition of fraction? If any two numbers can be expressed as p by q, where p and q are whole numbers, where p and q are whole numbers, is called a fraction. So if any two numbers can be expressed as p by q, where p and q are whole numbers, here in a rational numbers p and q are integers. So that is the difference between rational number and fraction. Now every rational number we can be written as terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. Every rational number we can be written as terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. Now what is a terminating decimal and what is a non-terminating recurring decimal? So what is the terminating decimal? Suppose we'll take examples. So that is a 7 by 8. 7 by 8. So 7 is divided by 8. Now so in a 8 table 7 will comes? No. So you put a point, we take a 0. So this will go to 8 7 of 8 8 64. 8 8 64. There is a, so here you take a borrow, there is a 10, 10 4. So 4 is taken from 10, that is a 6. Next to we take 0. This will go to 8 7 of 56. 4. Next to 8 5 of 40. So 7 by 8 is, we can print as 0.875. And also we will take 1 by 2. So 1 is divided by 2. So 0.25 is 10. So you observe here, remainder is 0. So numerator is divided by the denominator, then we will get a remainder is 0. We will get a remainder is 0. Then the type of rational numbers we call as a terminating decimals. So what is the definition of terminating decimal? So numerator is divided by denominator and we will get a remainder is 0. Then that rational number is called a terminating decimal. For example 7 by 8, examples 7 by 8, 1 by 2, 3 by 4, etc. Now, what is a non-terminating recurring decimal? So, for example, we will take one example, that is 15 by 9. So, 15 is the numerator, 9 is the denominator. So, this will cost to 9, 1, 9. So, 9 is taken from 15, that is 6. We put point, we take 0, 9, 7 is 63. 96 of 54, this will cost 96 of 54, remainder is 6. Next we take 0, this will cost again goes to 96. So again 96. So here we will get a remainder 0, no. And also in quotient numbers, last digit is repeating, last digit is repeating. So this type of rational numbers we call as a non-terminating recurring decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal. So what is the definition of non-terminating recurring decimal? So numerator is divided by denominator and will not get a remainder is zero, and last digit are some groups of digits repeat in their quotient is called a non-terminating recurring decimal. And examples are 15 by 9 and 1 by 3, 1 by 8, 17 by 8, etc. So you are find out 1 by 9, 2 by 9, 3 by 9, 4 by 5 and 35 by 9 are terminating or non-terminating recurring decimals. You are find out this one. Okay. So tomorrow we will continue the class.